We are recording on the cloud. Right, guys, so the session plan is on the right-hand side, which I think you can see. And we're going to work for a warm-up. And the theme is going to be about pacing, okay? So as we're working through the warm-up, I'll tell you all about the pacing. So we're going to start off with a 5-minute leg loop. So we're starting off at RPE 1, moving up to RPE 3, okay? So if you're starting, you'll stop, which is going to give you a countdown. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Right. So, here we go. Level 2. I'm not calling it the level 2 tour. That would be too obvious. So, this is just called level 2, which is probably even more obvious. But anyway, so we're starting off. We're doing 5 minutes RPE 1, so 5. So we're just working our way through. So just to remind you, RPE is a scale that goes from 1 to 10. 1 is basically really, really low level of exercise, i.e. sitting down. And RPE 10 is maximum. Okay, now, what we're doing is we're starting off at RPE 1, just gradually picking that up to RPE 3. Okay, so 4 minutes and let's go. I'm already out of breath after 1 minute, 4 seconds on RP1. But it works in me. Hopefully I can get fit at the same rate that you guys do. So our warm-up is slightly different and it's going to stay the same week to week. We'll do the same warm-up protocol. So warm-up level 2 is slightly kind of slightly briefer in a sense, actually, because we've got 5 minutes just getting the legs going. Then we're doing 5 warm-up reps, and those reps are at RPE 8. So 1 minute RPE 8, 1 minute RPE 2. That's side of the ground 5 times. And we then finish the warm-up with the transition, which is basically a recovery, which takes you to main set. So we're looking at pacing today. And what we're going to do is we're going to do 3 pacing exercises across the 3 different energy systems. So to remind you about the energy systems, we've got 3. Phosphocreatine, anaerobic glycolytic, also known as lactic acid, and the aerobic. Okay, so those are the 3 energy systems. Those energy systems are the ways that we resynthesize ATP. ATP, or adenosine triphosphate, is the molecule that makes a muscle contract. Okay? So that's the fuel. When we talk about carbohydrate is an energy source. Okay, but the fuel for muscular contraction is ATP. So we have 3 ways of resynthesizing ATP. To remind you, just give you a bit of a kind of a little crash course, a little reminder. The energy systems always overlap. So we're always using each of the 3 energy systems. It's just that we tend to use one of them predominantly. It's a slight simplification, but it's more or less what's going on. So when we do very high intensity, short duration effort of up to 10 seconds, we will be using mostly a phosphocreatine energy system. Okay. After around about 10 seconds, in actual fact probably closer to 8 seconds, the phosphocreatine is gone. And that means our power level drops. So we get a power decay after around about 5 to 10 seconds. Now, at that point, we continue working hard. We're trying to keep the pedals turning at the same rate. We then go into our anaerobic glycolytic system. that goes on for about 2 more minutes. And if we're still going as hard as we can, we're using most of the aerobic energy pathways, by then we're producing much less power. So what we're going to do after we finish the warm-up is we're going to try pacing efforts over each of those energy systems. And in 20 seconds, we're doing the first of our 4 minute reps. Okay, so count it down. We're going to be going into RP8 for 60 seconds at a time. Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. So RP8 now. right. So, coming up to 30 seconds here. Brilliant, well done guys, that's good. Two, one, go. through. 10 seconds. Do I pace 10 seconds? Or can I go literally as hard as I can for 10 seconds? Okay, that's the question you need to be asking yourself. So once you've completed that effort, think to yourself, am I actually pacing this 10 seconds? Okay, that's the question to ask. Got another 60 seconds to go. So we're aiming to get energy through the phosphocreatine energy system. So this has to be maximum. But if you go out as hard as you can you actually keep the same level of effort going for 10 seconds? Or do you fade? Because if you fade, then you've not paced it well. Then is there such a thing as pacing for 10 seconds? I know the answer to that question. I'm deliberately not going to give you the answer. I want you to be thinking about whether 10 seconds is something that actually should be paced, or whether you can actually go as hard as you can and not fade. Get ready to go in 10 seconds. So select your gearing. Nice high gear. Get ready. Because we're going to go flat out in 3, 2, 1, go.
Let's dig in, keep it going, don't fade.
going. Another 25 seconds. Maybe 20 more seconds. No failure. Program is taken to the next level a little bit. we start to take more consideration of time duration. So RPE 910 is probably where we're going to be at the end of this 12-minute hours.
Come on. 2 minutes, 12 minutes. Pace the game.
great. Okay, good, awesome, perfect. Really awesome. Okay? Your heart rate is probably close to maximum. If you stop pedaling now, the blood is still in contact with the heart. It starts to connect and cool the muscles and the veins. If you stop pedaling, you move the pedal off firmly to squeeze the veins to send the same amount of blood back to the heart. Otherwise, you start to pull the veins. So do not stop pedaling, your legs tensing. Keep the levels turning. Right, guys, that was 12-minute paced effort. Okay? Paced maximum. Now, there are two things going on here. One, pacing. Two, target. Okay? So your target for these intervals has been time. Okay? That's been your pacing target. Now, time looks very different to distance. Let's say, for example, rather than 12 minutes, I said to you, okay, let's do a 5-mile effort. Okay? Your pacing strategy would be similar but different. Because when you're pacing for a distance, of course, the quicker you go, the shorter that time is. But it doesn't matter how hard you go for 12 minutes, it's still 12 minutes. Sounds obvious, but great to say. Now, there are generally three pacing strategies when it comes to distance. I'm going to stop. So I just want to finish what I say here. When you pace over distance, you can do what's called a neutral split, which means the first half of the effort, first 2.5 miles, say 5 miles, is the same pace as the second 2.5 miles. You can do a positive split, where the first 2.5 are faster than the second 2.5. Or you can do a negative split, where first half is slower than the second half. It's called a negative split. Most times, most riders, referring to pros now, men's and women's, tend to favour negative splits. Yeah. Unless it's really, really short. So they tend to favour negative splits on time trials. A negative split, you aim to go slightly quicker than the first half. Because if you go too slow in the first half, you will lose the potential gains of going faster in the second half. So there is a real skill to that. Pacing is a skill. Time trialing is a skill. And this is why you can see some really, really good riders who actually lack the ability to time trial because they don't practice the skills amongst other things. Right, we need to start the cool down. So I'm going to start the cool down in 20 seconds. Okay, I'm going to slightly over my 2-minute recovery. So I just wanted to kind of communicate that to you guys. So in 10 seconds, we're going to start our 5-minute cool down. So what will involve is going now, taking the intensity up. So I'm going to lift the intensity to RPE 4. Okay, through now. So I want you guys to hit RPE 4. And then what we're going to do is we're going to progressively bring that down. Okay? So we had a recovery. And now we're going to recovery. We cool down on not the same thing. Okay, cool down is when we aim to get the body back down to closer to its resting state. So around about 25 seconds, I just want you to knock it down from RP4 to RP3. So, already, you've experienced pacing. You've experienced pacing against three different energy systems. And our targets have been time, which is why we knew we were going to hit those energy systems, because they were time targets. Acknowledge that when we're targeting distance, their pacing strategies tend to look slightly different, although they are similar to what we experience. Because we can use either a positive, negative, or neutral split. pace of time trialing. That is, don't chase the pain. And really what he means by that is the next split. Because if you go out fast, if you go out to try and do a fast time without going too hard, then you're subconsciously actually creating a negative split situation. So the pain will come to you. So when it's over the halfway point, you're very, very well tuned in to what you're capable of holding for the next however many miles or kilometers it is. If you guys want to, get better at time trialing, or point-to-point efforts, even if it's on your Saturday or Sunday loop, and you have Strava segments, for instance. Strava segments are still time trials, okay? Unless you're holding onto a Carl Brinkman, in which case it's cheating. Strava segments are effective time trials. So if you're a Stravaist and you like segments, then remember, maximum does not necessarily mean maximum, because even at 10 seconds, maximum effort at 10 seconds will cause you to fade before that 10 seconds is up. So maximum is relative to either the distance or the time. And of course, the distance and the time are connected, because the faster you get, the greater the distance, the shorter the effort. Okay? Well, maximum is always a relative term. Went out on the weekend, you did, let's say you were doing 50 miles a week, 50 miles as hard as I can. Well, you wouldn't do the first 10 seconds like we have the first 10 seconds here. Okay, that would be absolutely insane. That's only going to make you slower. Okay, so maximum is relative to the distance and the time. So you have to bear that in mind when we're talking about RPEs. So we've got just over another minute, so we should be round about RPE 1.5 now. Okay, so maybe just go into a slightly lower gear, slightly less resistance. This is great though, this feels like this feels normal. It didn't feel normal when we stopped doing all these sessions. Well, it's missing gear this week. Just for the record, somebody asked me actually in the summer, are you actually going as hard as we are because you do a lot of talking? Well, I'm not going as hard as you are, okay? I'm going about as hard as I can and kind of trying to remain coherent at the same time. And you might even be thinking one day, I'm coherent. In which case, it probably needs to go even easier. No, I'm not actually going as hard as you guys are. I can see how hard you guys are going, I can see something on the screen. And Beth, in my sort of conversations, 12-minute max efforts. So it's kind of more of a question of do as I say, not do as I do, because I'm delivering the same results. Right guys, that's exit to the end of the session. So, great to be back. I hope you guys enjoyed that. If anybody enjoyed